So let's go down to the bottom left of our panel with our footage in it, and you're gonna see our view options here, and we're gonna click on the right option called Freeform View. Now, Freeform View is a relatively new feature that Adobe released in early 2019, and it definitely has its perks, but I'm gonna kind of breeze through it because in my opinion, it has a major shortcoming that hopefully Adobe will sort out in the future. Now, the first thing I'm gonna do in this view is I'm gonna go to the top left of my keyboard and I'm gonna press what I call the squiggle key, and that's going to maximize this panel with our Freeform View in it. So in Freeform View here, you're gonna see that we've got icons just like an icon view, but things are a little different. So we can actually move these icons anywhere we want to because this is Freeform, baby. So we can stack them on top of each other. It's kind of like, you know, if we were stacking cards on top of a table, right? And so this view makes it really easy for us to visually lay out our sequence. So let me show you how. So first, let's clean up this hot mess that we've made here. And so I'm gonna right click and I'm gonna select Align to Grid. And now you'll see that that has snapped our footage into a nice clean grid here. And now if I wanted to quickly get my clips categorized, I could organize it into groups. Like I could put all of my food shots over here, all my drink shots over here, all my picnic basket shots over here, and so on. But in this case, our clips were taken in chronological order, and so I just wanna sort them by name. So I'm gonna right click here, I'm gonna go to Reset to Grid, and I'm gonna tell Premiere to order these clips by name. So now we've got everything in a grid organized by name. Okay, now I can see that the last clip that we added to the timeline was this one because we can see these little usage icons down here in the bottom right highlighted in blue. And so I'm gonna select that clip and then all of the other clips before it, and I'm just gonna drag them off the screen because we don't need them. They've already been added. Bye-bye. Okay, now I'm gonna pick out some good shots and trim them up, and I can just hover over these and press I to set the endpoint, press O to set the out point, just like we did before. Okay, so now I've laid out the next few clips that I wanna add to my timeline, and you can see that they're laid out kinda like a comic strip. So this is a nice way to visualize your sequence. And let's say that maybe I'm looking at this and I think that, you know, this shot should go before this shot, then I can arrange it right here in Freeform View before I add to my timeline. So let's press the squiggle key up at the top left of our keyboard and minimize this panel so that it's not full screen. And then let's adjust this slider here so that our icons are a little bit smaller and we can see things a little better, and we'll stretch this panel out. And we'll see this is where we want our next clips to go. And so to add them to our timeline, we should just select those clips and press the comma key, and then they'll be added, right? Well, they were added to the timeline, but you'll notice that they were not added in the order that we had them over here in Freeform View. So these two clips right here are swapped in the timeline. And that right there is my issue with Freeform View, because this is a great way to lay out your footage and get it in a nice sequence, but then Premiere doesn't respect the order that you created when you add it to the timeline. The only way to keep your clips in order, if you're gonna put them on your timeline from Freeform View, is you have to shift click one by one all of the clips in the order that you want them to be, and then drag them to your timeline. So if you love Freeform View enough, then maybe all that clicking will be worth it to you. Hey y'all, I'm Mary. I'm a filmmaker and I teach a course showing you how to make videos for your brand. And this is a preview of one of the editing lessons. And if you want to watch the full lesson, you can do that online for free at the link on screen or in the description below. All right, bye y'all.